Hey guys, it's your girl Bright Eyes Open, and you know, so this evening I am going to be making some lasagna.
I already have my meat sauce prepped here that I just took off the stove.
I have my pan here, and I have all of my different cheeses. I am going to use the oven ready lasagna noodles, opposed to boiling the lasagna noodles like they originally did back in the day. So this is just a little more convenient. Alright, so I am going to start with gonna take some ricotta. And I'm just going to put some ricotta in a bowl.
After a week of frigid temperatures and power outages, Texans are now
struggling. And I'm going to mix this with some Parmesan cheese. A little more parm. Okay, so this is just ricotta and Parmesan cheese in here. A nice little smooth consistency. So I'm going to lightly oil my pan, and I'm going to use Pam, and bam with the pan. So I'm just going to lightly oil my pan, oil my pan with the pan, and I am going to start with sauce first. So I'm going to so you guys can see what's going on here. So we are going to go in with some sauce.
Make your life easier with the Weather Authority app. Click on more for hour-by-hour updates, the 10-day forecast, and video updates from the Weather Authority. Search WJXT for the free app in your Apple or your Android app store.
Florida officially hit another grim milestone under the COVID-19 pandemic today. The state health department reported another 224 coronavirus-related deaths, bringing Florida's death toll to more than 30,000, just less than a year after the pandemic began. And more than 6,600 COVID-19 cases were reported in the state today, bringing Florida's total number of cases to more than 1.85 million.
I'm just going to use a big spoon so that I can spread it.
There is some promising news.
Because you want to cover each corner.
22,000 people were given their first dose
of your pan
yesterday,
with sauce, because you don't want the noodles to to be directly on the bottom of your pan because it will burn. So you want to make sure that the bottom of your pan is covered, each corner, with sauce. Let me just show you guys what I'm doing here. See that? Each corner of the pan is covered with the sauce. So let's bring out that here. All right, so first layer, sauce. Second layer is going to be, I'm going to add lasagna noodles.
A new study shows fewer people of color are participating in U.S.-based vaccine trials than white people.
And it's okay if you have to overlay your noodle a little bit, that's fine. So let me just show you guys as I'm going along. So that's my first layer of noodles, and you see how I overlapped the noodles just a little bit. That's okay. So now I'm going to go over my noodles with my ricotta cheese spread. Remember, I mixed ricotta with Parmesan, and that's what's in this bowl right here. And so I am going to just take my cheese spread and I'm going to spread that over my lasagna noodles. Just kind of try to make sure you're covered. You got cheese covering each noodle. Doesn't have to be perfect, because this dish is definitely nice and sloppy to make. Y'all can see that. Trying to let y'all see everything I'm doing, each step I do. So after my lasagna noodles, I just put the ricotta cheese spread that I mixed in the bowl, and then I'm gonna go over that with some mozzarella. I'm just gonna sprinkle some mozzarella. About to go down. And now I have different cheeses here, you guys. Feel free to use whatever type of cheese you like, but I have about 5 to 6 different cheeses here. So I like it cheesy. I get cheesy with it. All right, so after this layer of cheese here, we're going to go back in, and we're going to put some more sauce. And we're going to just spread that sauce around. Get on down. Can I get down? Get on down. Can I get down? Can I get down? Get on down. Can I get down? Nice slow layer.
The threat of nuclear proliferation also continues to require careful diplomacy and cooperation.
So y'all see that, you guys? Okay, so that's my second layer of meat, and I'm gonna go back in. And we're gonna, oops, let's move this stuff out your way so y'all can see what's going on. There we go. So we're gonna go back in, and we're gonna take some of our lasagna noodles. We're gonna go back in with the lasagna noodles.
Worrisome at what they're asking you to do.
And now remember the first layer of noodles I put on straight across. Well, this layer I put on up and down just because I want my noodle to, when you go to cut your slices of lasagna, you want to make sure you're getting noodle in each slice, okay? So that's why I did it like that. Now I'm going to go on top of my noodles again with my ricotta cheese spread. I have to hold my noodle in place. My noodle in place because it gets a little messy and crazy in this pan trying to spread the ricotta cheese on top of the noodles. So you kind of got to hold it in place to get the cheese all over your noodle the way you want it to be, or over that noodle. And like I said, my noodles are overlapped a little bit, and that's fine. Second layer of my ricotta cheese spread that I remember I mixed the ricotta cheese with the Parmesan, so that's my second layer of my cheese spread, and I'm gonna go on top of that. We're gonna go on top of that with the mixed cheeses. So we got the mozzarella. Four cheese mix here. Then I have mozzarella. I have my regular cheddar. I also have a Mexican style. So I'm getting cheesy. It's pretty cheesy. Cheesy. Okay. So after that, I'm gonna go back on top with some more meat, the meat sauce. And when you do your meat sauce, Bright Thang Gang, you can make your meat sauce just like you would make spaghetti. And you add whatever you want to. You add whatever you want to it. Your onions, your peppers. I don't like mushrooms, so I didn't add mushrooms, but some people like mushrooms, you can add mushrooms. It's whatever your taste buds, whatever your preference. It's really up to you. Up to you guys. And I think this might be, this is going to be my last. This is going to be my last load of meat. You guys. Well, my last layer. This is my last layer of meat. And you want to make sure you got that all over mixed, covering your noodle. Covering that noodle. See how I pretty much covered the whole top there? Yes. still have a little more of this. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to go back in with one more layer. One more layer. Do I want to do one more layer? No, you guys. Should I? I got three layers of noodles in here. Should I just leave it like that, y'all? You know what? I'm gonna do one more layer. One more layer of noodles. I'm gonna do another layer of noodles, y'all. This is how it's looking so far, you guys. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go back on top with some cheese. I'm gonna go on top with some cheese. Mozzarella.
Kim Kardashian West has filed for divorce. She and rapper Kanye West married in Italy in 2014. The two have four children together. A representative from Kardashian West did confirm the divorce filing today, but no other details were immediately available.
Get your brackets ready. March Madness is happening this year.
Here you go. A little bit more sauce on top, and this is the sauce that I used when I cooked my meat and made my meat sauce. This is the sauce that I used, the ragu simply. I know I got cheese in my mouth, y'all. Don't worry about that. So I'm just gonna go on top. Because the last layer of noodle I put on, I don't want it to be dry. So I'm going to go on top with a little bit of the red goose. So my noodles are not. Just like that. Yeah.
musical, and beautiful. Black stories are here.
Introducing the Black Experience on Xfinity, a new destination that's the ultimate in Black storytelling. Get Xfinity Internet for just $25 a month for 12 months, and you'll get a flexible streaming device that puts all your favorite apps right on your TV. Plus, the Black Experience is included at no additional cost.
It's a new place to experience all stories, only on Xfinity.
Call Clear and visit today. This is an important message for
patients. Hold on, you guys. We're going to do a little bit more.
A number of patients have alleged pain, infection, and joint instability after knee and hip surgery performed by Dr. Keegan. If Dr. Keegan were to step off the floor and you were experiencing pain, joint instability, infection, knee and revision surgery, or revision surgery, you may be entitled to substantial compensation.
So I need every
consultation from an experienced and compassionate attorney. Call the number on the screen. Time limits apply. Call now.
This is how it looks, and we're going to cover that up, and we're going to put it in the oven, and if you see on the side, you see it's different layers there. I have four layers of noodles, so you guys,
wait up, how did you have a new stuff crush? Oh, we did it all our tweets, DMs, and carrier pigeons worked. We just stuck crush.
product. That's how my lasagna came out. And I am going to put that in the oven. I have my oven preheated to 375. I'm going to put that in the oven for about 20, 25 minutes. Then I'm going to take the aluminum foil off and leave it in there for about another 15, 20 minutes without the aluminum foil on. And then that's it. You let it cool off for about 10 minutes or so. And slice and dig in. And until next time, you guys have a beautiful, beautiful, blessed evening. Make sure you surround yourself with nothing but positive energy, positive people, and positive thoughts. And try you some lasagna. And I'm out.